We're okay. Now, gentlemen, we went over the rules in the dressing room. Okay. I want to caution you to keep this fight clean at all times. Protect yourself at all times. And what I say, you must obey. Good luck. Touch them up.
All right, here we go. This fight scheduled for 4 rounds in the junior lightweight division. A pair of Puerto Rican fighters going at it here. Frevion Gonzalez taking on Carlos Marrero. Frevion in the white trunks with the red trim and Marrero in the white trunks with yellow trim.
Frevion Gonzalez, an orthodox boxer that can switch to southpaw, and he does it very well.
And for Marrero, this is the first fight in 2020. It's actually his first fight in the calendar year and the first time fighting away from the East Coast. As a lot of fighters dream about the opportunity to fight in Las Vegas, and this is his chance.
Work out. Work out. Stop, stop. Step back, swing. Let go. Let go.
Frevion Gonzalez is a stablemate of Jose Pedraza. Says that he kind of tries to mirror his style after Pedraza. You can kind of see some of that with the way that he boxes, and he's very smooth and lands a nice right hand there to the body. And as Manny mentioned, does switch orthodox to southpaw quite frequently.
Work out.
Marrero lands a good right hand to the body right underneath that left guard of Gonzalez.
Gonzalez is actually being more aggressive this time around. Coming in with a little bit of sense of urgency, if you will, trying to get that knockout. He said he wants to get signed by Top Rank,
yes.
So that shows you that he's eager to get that knockout. He's eager to make a good impression on the promoter.
Frevion has had an extensive amateur career, won multiple national tournaments, had over 200 amateur fights. This is just his 4th fight as a professional, but training alongside the likes of Pedraza and being on his undercards, he knows each and every time he gets the opportunity to fight in front of those top-ranked matchmakers, he wants to capitalize on it because he is looking for that professional contract, promotional contract.
Yes, indeed.
As a lot of these guys are, and that's what this opportunity for a lot of these undercard guys has been about. You answer the call and you get to show what you're made of, not only to get a paycheck and to get an opportunity on ESPN, but also maybe to earn you a contract.
Absolutely. You know, this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for a lot of these kids. So they're going to go out there and do the best they can to make a good impression in front of the promoter.
A nice left hand. It's gotten in a few times from Marrero as Gonzalez continues to put on the pressure and land combinations of his own. Some good action here in round one.
Definitely a good round. Good body work there by Gonzalez to finish to the head as he should. Go to the body and the head will follow, as they say. Good combination punching by Marrero as well.
He's got some good counter shots.
Gonzalez not boxing this time around. He's trying to make it a fight.
Yeah, good start here. It's a 4-rounder. Let's not waste any time, right?
Like I said, you got to have a sense of urgency when you're fighting a 4-round fight. So there you go. Good first round by both fighters.
And there is Luis Espada, also head trainer of Pedraza. Okay. And Nate Torres and Amiel Rivera in the corner of Marrero.
But you need to throw more than one shot. You see what he got?
And there is one half of our main event later on tonight. That is John Jose Cepeda, 32-2 with 25 knockouts. He will be taking on Ivan Baranchek in our main event. There is Ivan, 20-1 with 13 KOs. I cannot wait for this fight. We've had to wait even longer because of the injury that Baranchek suffered in sparring, but it's finally taking place in our main event later tonight. A couple of top-ranked 140 pounders going at it for that WBC title eliminator in our main event. But a few fights still to go before we get there. Christina Poncher and Manny Robles here with you, calling the fights live from a studio not in Las Vegas but in Southern California. So thank you to everyone that's been joining us on our undercard. We've had a knockout in every fight so far.
And there we see Gonzalez right away trying to fight Marrero on the inside, backing him up. And Marrero isn't going anywhere. Nice counter punch there by counter right hander by Marrero there.
Yeah, he's got
taking
some
his time.
Nice counter shots.
Jabbing to the body by Gonzalez, switching to the southpaw stance.
Letting that nice lead right hand out of the southpaw stance there is Gonzalez, and then a strong jab there to set up that combination. He's doing a good job, Manny, of using punch variety. He's gone down to the body, he's come up top, he's switched stances. Marrero has a couple good counters in there, but Gonzalez doing some nice work showing some punch variation.
But maybe not enough, right? I mean, he's able, Marrero's able to come back and counter, but he counters, he comes back with one punch
one
as opposed to following up.
Yep.
Meanwhile, Gonzalez is definitely staying busy. Good combination output there. Stepping and turning at sidestep, very nice there by Gonzalez. He's thinking, you know, he's not just releasing and throwing punches. He's moving his side to side, reading angles, trying to break his fighter down in Marrero. Nice, nice left there by Gonzalez. Left hand lead there to follow up with the right hook.
Really good work here in round two from Frevian Gonzalez.
Not a very common name, is it? Frevian Gonzalez. Frevian, that is.
Yeah, it doesn't just roll off the tongue so easy.
That is correct.
How about his nickname, Little Giant?
Little Giant. I like that, Little Giant. He's looking like a big giant right now as we speak. Nice left hand lead by Gonzalez. Trying to stay on top of his opponent. There we go, switching back to the orthodox stance. Once you get on the inside, I feel like it doesn't really matter whether you're right if you switch to the conventional stance or orthodox. I mean, I'm sorry, or the softball stance.
Work out.
Why is that?
I feel that it doesn't really make a big difference because now you're in so close that it doesn't make a difference to the opponent. Yeah, because you're in so close. You can do that from mid-range or from a far range. That makes it harder for your opponent to catch you and to set up.
But oftentimes on the inside, a lot of these guys almost square up.
Yeah,
as long as
correct.
You get your head off the line, but when you're squared up, it doesn't really dictate which foot is in front because it's not by very much distance.
That is correct, Christina. That's a good call.
As we take a look at the replay here, pretty much all Frevian Gonzalez there in round two.
Yes, there we see the uppercut, there we see the left hand lead. Right hook, straight left, a left again, left hook. Good work there by, good combination punching there by Gonzalez. Good punch placement, if you will. Eager to go out there and try to get that knockdown. And you can see, you can hear his coach encourage him to go out there and say, vamos, vamos, let's go.
Round three, the scheduled four rounder in the junior lightweight division. Christina Poncher and Manny Robles here with you. Really nice start to the first half of this fight from Frevian Gonzalez, and Moreto's been tough and has landed big left
nice.
Hand from Gonzalez there to start round three.
Nice left again, coming back with the same punch.
And Moreto gets a good counter right hand, and that's what he's done the best is counter punch, but it's just been, as Manny mentioned, with one counter shot, nothing else coming behind it.
But as you can see from that mid-range, it makes it more difficult for Marrero to try and guess what Gonzalez is coming in with, because he's jabbing to the body and coming over the top with that left hand.
Hits.
Nice step and turn there to the right.
Throws out right hand steps while he's throwing the left hand steps to the right hand side.
Step back.
Smart fighter, Gonzalez. Like I said, he's not just out there throwing punches and bunches. You know, he's systematically breaking his opponent down and making a good effort to try to get the stoppage. There's that left hand lead again.
La cabeza.
Touch and dig. As he should.
You talked about trying to get the stoppage, be a nice little feather in the cap of Fabián Gonzalez. Although Carlos Moreno has three losses on his record, all have been by decision. Never been stopped as a professional in his only six professional fights, but still.
Marrero's definitely a game fighter.
Yep.
Game fighter coming back. He's landing some good combinations of his own, but he's not doing enough. There's a nice step and turn there by Marrero to come back with that right hand. There's a nice right uppercut, but not following up.
Stop.
You gotta follow up.
Watch that hand.
Sometimes your best defense is your offense. So in order to do that, you gotta let go of those punches. You gotta let your hands go.
And Frevion doing that too, Manny, to your point, not everything coming with all that speed and power. Sometimes just to kind of keep your hands busy, even just tapping the gloves of Marrero, just to kind of keep him at bay.
No, definitely. And that's what you need to do. You need to set up your opponent. Not everything is power.
Nice left hooks to the body getting in from Marrero there. Some good body work here.
Definitely been an inside fight by both fighters.
Don't hold him.
Moreno has had some bright moments, but it's been the overwhelming activity from Gonzalez that is winning him these rounds. I mean, he's punching, you know, 3-1 on a lot of these occasions here.
Creating some nice angles at the same time there by Gonzalez. Good round, great round.
One more to go.
I would have to give this round to Fabián Gonzalez. He's definitely been controlling the tempo in this fight.
He is determined to deliver pain and punishment. That's it, TK, Emmanuel Navarrete.
Watch your head.
And Navarrete continues to pour it on here. That was a brutal beatdown.
Navarrete, he's just too strong.
And a knockdown beats him down again.
Looking forward to that fight. The vacant WBO world title fight, 12 rounds of action in the featherweight division, the featherweight debut, in fact, for Emmanuel Navarrete, taking on Ruben Villa. Navarrete is some kind of fighter, man. Every time I watch him fight, he impresses me more and more. How he made 122, I have no idea. But up to 126, where I'm sure he will continue his success.
Ruben Villa is no walk in the park.
Oh, not at all. Undefeated fighter, very talented team, corner, 18-0, 5 knockouts. Earned himself the opportunity to challenge for that world title.
Here we see Gonzalez and Marrero going straight at it. Not backing up. Both making it a good fight. Good crowd-pleasing fight. Good body work there by Gonzalez again. Left hand, right hand of the body, finishing to the head. Going by feel, Gonzalez is. Counter-punching, that is. Look at the way he keeps his guard up nice and high, nice and tight on the inside as he releases once he's done with his combinations. And you want to see that from a fighter. You want to see growth.
And just his fourth professional fight for Fabián Gonzalez. Nice left hand there. Catches Moreno pulling straight back from that exchange. And Moreno's had some good moments, has landed some good shots to the body, and knows at this point probably needs a knockout to win this fight. But nonetheless, has stayed up on his feet, never been down. Nice uppercut there with the right hand from Moreno, but Gonzalez putting in some solid work.
Definitely have to tip your head off to Marrero for making it a good fight as well. As you said, maybe not winning the fight, but not backing up from Gonzalez at all.
This is some tough matchmaking too for Fabián Gonzalez. I mean, you want to earn yourself a contract here, going with a guy that's never been stopped in only your fourth professional fight, and show us what you could do.
That is correct.
Yeah.
And don't forget that Gonzalez in his last fight fought an opponent that was also 2-0.
Sure did. And that fight went the distance, and winning a unanimous decision. So.
Undefeated fighter. this Marrero kid, although he's two wins, three losses, one draw, he's definitely game.
And those are the type of fighters, too, that earn themselves other opportunities on cards like this.
Yes, indeed. And then the fighters got to understand, a fighter like Gonzalez has to understand that knockouts, you know, they're going to come. You keep working, and you keep developing, you keep growing. He's
19 years old.
He's 19 years old. This kid hasn't even developed his man strength yet.
Marrero, 27 years old, as he gets tagged with a little clean shot there from Gonzalez. As we get to the closing seconds of this one, a nice fight from beginning to end here, as both guys have let their hands go, but it's been Gonzalez and the consistent work rate he's been able to maintain rounds 1 through 4 that likely earned him the victory tonight. But my hat's off to Carlos Marrero for putting on a tough performance, landing some good counter shots that gave him some bright spots throughout the fight, but a workmanlike rate and performance from Frevion Gonzalez tonight.
Absolutely, what a good fight. Also by Marrero, you gotta, again, yes, gotta tip your head off to Marrero for making it a good fight. It takes two to tango.
Either way, Puerto Rico wins tonight, right?
That's for sure. La Isla del Encanto, as they call it.
Love it. These are the type of fights, too, where I just miss fans being there. I mean, God, I've witnessed some amazing atmospheres of Madison Square Garden and, you know, Puerto Rican Day weekend with Miguel Cotto. And, I long for those days, and I can't wait till boxing's back with fans, and, you know, we can really hear the passion that this sport and these fighters thrive on when they're in the ring. As we take a look at some of the replays as we await the decision.
Here we go. Good body work by both fighters there. And then we see Gonzalez leading off with that left hand, straight left, right hook, left hook, left hand. Just, again, systematically broke Marrero down by going to the body, going to the head, coming over the top with that right hand, just like he did with his left. I like what I saw from Gonzalez today. He was eager to get that knockdown, but nonetheless, although he didn't get the knockout, he looked. I like what I saw from him. That determination, you know, the wanting to go out there and give it his all, which he did. And I see him, you know, winning a unanimous decision tonight.
All right, here's Mark Chinook.
Ladies and gentlemen, here inside MGM Grand, after 4 rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for the official decision. Adelaide Bird has the bout 38-38. Dave Moretti and Chris Flores have the bout 40-36. Declaring your winner by majority decision, Frevion Pequeño Gigante Gonzalez.
All right, congratulations to Frevion Gonzalez winning a majority.